So this is going to lead us to the concept of expectation maximization. So expectation maximization is actually, at an algorithmic level, it's surprisingly similar to k-means. So what we're going to do is we're going to tick-tock back and forth between two different probabilistic calculations. So you see that? I kind of drew it like the other one.
Mm-hmm.
The names of the two phases are expectation and maximization. Sort of, you know, our name is our algorithm.
I like that.
So what they're going to do is we're going to move back and forth between a soft clustering and computing the means from the soft cluster. So the soft clustering goes like this. This probabilistic indicator variable, Zij, represents the likelihood that data element I comes from cluster J. And so the way we're going to do that, since we're in the maximum likelihood setting, is to use Bayes' rule and say, well, that's going to be proportional to the probability that data element I was produced by cluster J, and then we have a normalization factor. Normally, we'd also have the prior in there. So why is the prior gone, Charles?
Well, because you said it was a maximum likelihood scenario.
Yeah, right. And we talked about how that just meant that it was uniform, and that allowed us to just leave that component out. It's not going to have any impact on the normalization.
Right.
So that's what the Z step is. If we had the clusters, if we knew where the means were, then we could compute how likely it is that the data would come from the means. And that's just this calculation here. So that's computing the expectation, defining the Z variables from the mu, the centers. We're going to pass that information, that clustering information Z, over to the maximization step. What the maximization step is going to say is, okay, well, if that's the clustering, we can compute the means from those clusters. All we have to do is just take the average variable value, right? So the average of the xi's within each cluster j, what's the likelihood it came from cluster j? And then again, we have to normalize. If you think of this as being a 0-1 indicator variable, then really it is just the average of the things we assign to that cluster. But here, we actually are kind of soft assigning. So we could have half of one of the data points in there, and it only counts half towards the average. And we could have a tenth in one, another place, and a whole value in another place. And so we're just doing this weighted average of the data points.
So can I ask you a question, Michael?
Yeah, shoot.
So this makes sense to me. And I even get that for the Gaussian case, the Zi variable always be non-zero in the end, because there's always some probability that it comes from some Gaussian, because they have infinite extent. So this all makes sense to me. Is there a way to take exactly this algorithm and turn it into k-means? I'm staring at it, and it feels like if all your probabilities were ones and zeros, you would end up with exactly k-means, I think.
I don't know. I never really thought about that. Let's think about that for a moment. Certainly the case, if all the z variables were 0, 1, then the maximization step would be the means, which is what k-means does.
Mm-hmm.
Then what would happen? We send these means back, and what we do in k-means is we say each data point belongs to its closest center,
mm-hmm.
which is very similar, actually, to what this does, except that here we then make it proportional. So I guess it would be exactly that if we made these clustering assignments, push them to 0 or 1, depending on which was the most likely cluster.
Right. So if you made it so that the probability of being to a cluster actually depends upon all the clusters, and you always got a 1 or a 0, basically this was like a hidden argmax kind of a thing, or hidden max or something, then you would end up with exactly k-means.
I think you're right.
Huh.
Yeah, I never thought about that.
Okay.
So it really does end up being an awful lot like the k-means algorithm, which is improving in the error metric, this squared error metric. This is actually going to be improving in a probabilistic metric, right? That the data is going to be more and more likely over time.
That makes sense.